Hi, hope you are doing well. In the last part, we saw that Chu Xiao, the Xiu Li army, won the battle, but the Xia army did not make the way to let them leave the border. September 20th, it snowed. At this juncture, snow would not be too heavy yet, but it continuously snowed for 2 days. Xiu Li army's ration had been almost depleted, and if not for the fact that some of the civilians had bought some food, they may have started starving long ago. All the tents were allocated to the civilians, yet every night there were elderly and children who froze to death. Medicine had run out as well, and injured soldier could not even get a sip of warm water. Chu Xiao could only helplessly watch as the coldness and injuries robbed the lives of the soldier who could withstand even the tremendous might of the Xia army. Each time she saw that a soldier had died or a child was trembling in the wind, she felt an urge to rush back to the Longin Pass to apologize to Yanshun and plead for him to save those innocent people. Helplessly, she smiled and could only feel that strength had left her body. Yanshun was really the one who understood her the most. Perhaps he had known long ago that this would happen. She was never scared of war, killing, or even death, but her Achilles heel was that she would never allow people who loved and supported her to die meaninglessly. In the past 2 days, she attempted to break through the encirclement 4 times. And she had been unsuccessful. Yuan Yang adopted a full defense formation. Not only did Prince Yang not face them in front combat, he did not bother with their attack either. Each time the Xiu Li army charged up, they were merely welcomed by a barrage of arrows, resulting in dozens of bodies being left behind. On the night of September 22nd, a snowstorm began. The temperature dropped drastically. In just half a night, there were over 50 deaths among the injured soldiers and over 80 deaths among the civilians. The civilians finally reached their limit. As a middle-aged woman left the camp and rushed to the Longin Pass to request entry, following which more and more civilians leapt as they trembled in the frigid winds towards the fort. In this life and death situation, the fear of death had finally won their conscience. The civilians abandoned this army that had fought to the end to defend and charged back to their homeland. The soldiers of Xiu Li army silently watched as everything unfolded. No one said anything, and no one tried to stop them. They merely watched these people who were crying and emotionlessly let them go. A sobbing elderly walked over to Chu Xiao. In his embrace was a child whose breathing had already weakened to the point that one could barely hear it. With his face full of humiliation, he tried to say something, but all that came out were weeping sound. The child was already completely pale. Chu Xiao could tell that if he did not quickly go someplace warm, he would die very soon. Chu Xiao felt as though Her throat was being choked by something. She was not angry, neither did she feel sad. Of course, she did not blame them for abandoning her. As a soldier, she had no excuse when all she could do was watch her countrymen die one by one. Unable to protect them, she could no longer bear to see that guilty gaze of the old man. Because she felt even more guilty, ridden deep down, she could only lower her head in silence, expressing her emotion, sorry. A top long in pass torch gradually started to light up. Under the pass, there were countless elderly children, women trembling forth. People shouted, open the gates, in unison, with a sense of despair and fear in their voice. At the end of the day, they were normal civilians. Their only wish was to survive, and sometimes they merely wished to live a better life. In the intensifying snowstorm, the entire landscape turned white. The officer atop the city walls shouted, "Do not approach! Back off! Back off!" Yet no one bothered. His voice had been drowned out by the rowdy civilians. While crying, the civilians pounced onto the gate and, with all their strength, they knocked on it while roaring, "Open the gates! We are the citizens of Yanbei. Why do you refuse to open the gates?" The sounds pierced through the heavens. The warriors of Longin Pass were dumbfounded. They had all witnessed the battle that had taken place 2 days ago. At this very moment, none of them hoped to point their weapons at their past comrades. In addition, the ones knocking at their gate were mere civilians. They stood rooted to the ground, conflicted between their morals and duty. "Open the gates!" The civilians burst themselves against the city gate. Some lost their balance and fell down, only to be trampled into a bloody mass by the one who impatiently charged up. The sounds of wailing and shrieking echoed on the plains as the heavy snow continued to drift down, seemingly endless. "Back off! If not, we will shoot you." "Do not shoot us. We are mere civilians. Please, please save my child." The woman who ran off first knelt on the ground, holding up her child, who no longer had the energy to complain as she wailed, "You can refuse to save me, but please save my child. Open the gate, open the gate, let us in." Thank you for staying with me. Subscribe and like the video. Thank you.